It is very encouraging to me to know that it is at this COP that an inventory of the implementation of the Paris Agreement will be concluded. The Global Stocktaking Initiative will no doubt give us a clear picture that is more than anecdotal on progress towards achieving the Paris goal to limit global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, report released in March this year posits that there is a more than 50% chance that global temperature rise will reach or surpass 1.5 degrees Celsius between 2021 and 2040 across studied scenarios and under a high emissions pathway. This is not good for our planet and calls for bold and transformative action. Your Excellencies, last year at COP27, dubbed the Implementation COP, we came up with the Sharm el-Sheikh Implementation Plan, which was inspired by science as provided for by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. Having said that, it is critical that negotiations at COP28 result in strengthened actions and advancement of the Sharm el-Sheikh Implementation Plan. It is for this reason that Botswana supports the modalities of work as proposed by the COP28 United Arab Emirates Presidency. Recognizing that climate finance is an important enabler of climate action, it is imperative that climate finance is made available and accessible to developing countries. At the center of Botswana's radar screen, therefore, is the new collective quantified goal from the floor of the initially envisaged US $100 billion. In our quest to accelerate the implementation of our climate change agenda, we need to enhance our actions of building resilience and addressing loss and damage that is associated with the adverse impacts of climate change. It is our fervent hope that the operationalization of the loss and damage financial mechanism will be concluded during this COP. Excellencies, Botswana is making significant strides towards transitioning from coal-fired electricity to renewable energy. As part of implementing the energy policy and renewable energy strategy, the government of Botswana has made a decision to increase renewable energy penetration from 2% to 30% by 2030. Our second transitional national development plan prioritizes climate change. This has enabled the integration of climate change risks into all aspects of planning, decision-making, and implementation. As a developing country, Botswana prioritizes adaptation as it reduces the vulnerability of communities to climate-related hazards, and in so doing, protecting livelihoods and ecosystems, as well as enabling them to be more resilient. Some of the adaptation actions implemented by Botswana include development of drought-tolerant crop and livestock species, the north-south water pipeline that transfers bulk water to the southern parts of the country where there is a deficit. Excellencies, I note with satisfaction the increased number of youth organizations involved in the intergovernmental climate change process. This will indeed ensure effective participation of the youth in climate change policy decision-making processes. In my capacity as a global chair of the group of LLDCs, I wish to declare the intention of the group to participate in climate change negotiations as a group. In this regard, we seek the support of the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate to provide the necessary assistance for the group to achieve this objective. Let me conclude by pledging my support to the COP presidency as you direct the debates towards timely results regarding implementation, particularly climate finance for adaptation and mitigation actions, technology development and research, and conclusion of the modalities of the Loss and Damage Fund. I thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Your Excellency. It is now my pleasure to welcome His Excellency Mr. Semuku Meliet Kone, Vice President of Cote d'Ivoire. Your Excellency, you have the floor.
Monsieur le Président des Émirats Arabes Unis, Monsieur le Président de la COP28, Excellences, Mesdames et Messieurs les chefs d'État et de gouvernement, il m'est particulièrement agréable d'adresser les salutations de Son Excellence Monsieur Alassane Ouattara, Président de la République de Côte d'Ivoire, à ses pairs et à tous les délégués participant à cette COP28. La Côte d'Ivoire se félicite de la tenue de cette conférence des parties aux Émirats Arabes Unis et salue l'engagement du pays hôte à œuvrer avec le soutien de tous les États en faveur du succès de nos travaux. Excellences, Mesdames et Messieurs, la COP28 se tient au moment où la planète connaît